Hello, and welcome to Keeping the Pace. My name is Jeremy Werdell, and I'm the project scientist of the upcoming NASA Plankton, Aerosol, Cloud, Ocean Ecosystem mission. In this presentation, I'll describe the mission and share its latest news. PACE is NASA's next great investment in ocean color, cloud, and aerosol data records to enable continued and advanced insight in oceanographic and atmospheric responses to Earth's changing climate. Specifically, PACE will join the NASA fleet of Earth-observing satellite missions tasked with monitoring ocean biology and biogeochemistry, atmospheric aerosols, clouds, and land. Its payload consists of three instruments. The primary instrument is a hyperspectral radiometer named the Ocean Color Instrument, and it's being built at NASA Goddard Space Flight Center. The payload also hosts two contributed multi-angle polarimeters. The first is named HARP-2, and it's being contributed by the University of Maryland, Baltimore County. The second is named SPECS-1, and it's being contributed by a consortium of organizations in the Netherlands. While the mission is not quite 6 years old, the idea of PACE has been around for nearly two decades. In fact, its concept was first conceived of after evaluating the successes, as well as the limitations, of early satellite ocean color instruments. PACE will stand on the shoulder of some of these giants, including Seewis, MODIS, and VIRS, as well as Polder and MISER. As for the meat and potatoes that you really want to know about the mission, here are some key characteristics. PACE will launch from a Falcon 9 from Kennedy Space Center in Florida in mid to late 2023. Its altitude will be 676.5 kilometers, and it'll have a polar ascending sun-synchronous orbit with a 98-degree inclination. Its local crossing time will be 1 p.m., and it'll have a 3-year design life, but don't worry, it's carrying 10 years worth of propellant. At its core, the PACE Ocean Color Instrument will be used for advanced studies of phytoplankton. NASA's heritage instruments are excellent at retrieving metrics of total biomass, such as near-surface concentrations of biogeochemical stocks. The colors of the ocean in this visualization represent different concentrations of chlorophyll A, a photosynthetic pigment found in all phytoplankton. As amazing as they are, however, heritage ocean color instruments have little information with which to identify specific phytoplankton communities that contribute to these total chlorophyll A observations. The members of these communities come in all shapes and sizes, each with a different role on their ecosystem. Better understanding of Earth's carbon cycle requires advanced knowledge of the spatiotemporal distributions of phytoplankton, which will only be possible with an instrument like OCI. Studies of our atmosphere face similar challenges. Advanced insight into Earth's radiation budget and the broad effects of our changing climate require improved knowledge of atmospheric aerosols. This visualization shows a model representation of the global spatiotemporal patterns of five atmospheric aerosols, namely carbon, sulfate, dust, sea salt, and nitrate. From our own personal experiences, we know that such aerosols come in many colors and forms. Looking even closer, however, reveals that they also come in all shapes and sizes. Improved understanding of these atmospheric constituents will only be possible with instruments such as the multi-angle polarimeters to be flown on PACE. The PACE payload will provide next-generation instrumentation to support these advanced studies of our home planet. The Ocean Color Instrument is a hyperspectral scanning radiometer that will measure continuously from 340 to 809 nanometers in 2.5-nanometer steps with a spectral resolution of 5 nanometers. It will also have the capability to measure shortwave infrared radiation at 7 discrete channels. OCI's global coverage will be 1 to 2 days with a ground pixel size of 1 square kilometer at nadir. Note that, like Seewis, it will tilt fore and aft 20 degrees to avoid sun glint. The two PACE polarimeters are CubeSat sized, but while they may be small, they are mighty, and their individual capabilities complement each other beautifully. HARP-2 is a multi-spectral instrument that ranges from the blue to the near-infrared, whereas SPECS-1 is a hyperspectral instrument that spans from the ultraviolet to the red. HARP-2 is a wide-swath instrument with 10 to 60 viewing angles, whereas SPECS 1 is a narrow swath instrument with 5 viewing angles. HARP 2 offers information on clouds that advances well beyond what is possible with OCI alone, whereas SPECS 1 offers advances for atmospheric aerosols. Together, this instrument combination provides a near-complete view of the... These passive radiometers work on similar principles. The color of the ocean or atmosphere is determined by the interactions of incident light with substances or particles present in the water or atmosphere. I'll provide a more detailed example that describes the principles of ocean color. Photons that reach and penetrate the sea surface have one of two fates. They get absorbed by seawater and its constituents, or they get scattered and redirected by seawater and its constituents. Both processes shape the spectral nature of the light field, as indicated by the colored arrows of various lengths. Noting that these phenomena, of course, occur when photons interact with any medium, not just seawater. Photons that ultimately emerge from the ocean and pass back through the atmosphere can be collected by the satellite instrument. And in the end, the core satellite data are accurate measurements of light intensity from ultraviolet to shortwave infrared wavelengths, which in turn can be used to derive geophysical products of interest. Next, I'd like to further explore two advances offered by the PACE Observatory. The first relates to OCI and its hyperspectral capabilities, that is, its move from multi-spectral radiometry to spectroscopy. The image on the left indicates the multi-spectral nature of heritage satellite instruments. These wavelengths were carefully chosen for use in the estimation of several geophysical products. They, however, are insufficient to resolve new and advanced data products, such as metrics of phytoplankton community composition. Let's explore a case study in the Arabian Sea, where a heterotrophic dinoflagellate named Noctiluca regularly outcompetes the baseline diatom population, which results in harmful algal blooms. We know the spectral nature of these phytoplankton, but our heritage satellite instruments have insufficient resolution to discriminate between the two species, as indicated by the plots on the right. Whereas VIRS only provides one unique spectral piece of information, PACE's OCI will paint a complete spectral picture to provide critical missing information to identify the phytoplankton present in this aquatic ecosystem. So while I've mentioned climate several times, you can see from this example that these measurements are also critical for economic and societal applications as well.
We're back to where we met you guys, and this is the water. So you're missed to come and collect this water. Look how green it is. The whole water is green. It's full of planktons.
The second advance I'd like to discuss is the addition of multi-angle polarimetry to the PACE Observatory, which will add dimensions of information beyond what is possible with OCI alone. As anyone with polarized sunglasses knows, polarized light offers a different way of seeing the world. Let's explore this further with a picture of the NASA Ames parking lot. Total intensity represents what our eyes see and what OCI will see. Both polarized intensity and the degree of linear polarization offer two new ways of seeing and understanding the composition of this parking lot. I'll draw your specific attention to the tree on the right in both images. The view of the polarized world changes with solar and viewing geometry as well. To further exploit this phenomenon, the PACE polarimeters will view Earth at multiple angles. The ability to look at polarized light fields at multiple view angles will provide a quantum leap forward in information content to reveal aerosol and hydrosol microphysical properties. PACE is currently in the mission phase where both engineering test units and flight units are being built. Let's take a deeper dive into the development of PACE's OCI instrument.
A big idea is coming to life. It's the PACE Ocean Color Instrument, OCI, designed to measure intensity of light across many bands of the electromagnetic spectrum. OCI is a one-of-a-kind instrument, and NASA engineers are building it now. The most advanced ocean color instrument ever, OCI will collect data to address essential scientific questions about our oceans and atmosphere. This is the engineering model to test the system that will ultimately be built to fly on PACE. engineers will test the model, and those tests will inform the construction of flight hardware. Science needs new tools to answer big questions. When it launches, the PACE mission will be an Earth science leader, and OCI will provide first-of-its-kind ocean observations, as well as capabilities to monitor atmospheric aerosols and clouds, continuing essential data records and extending our capabilities for a new generation.
The PACE mission has evolved from a decades-old idea into reality, and we're terribly excited to share this observatory with the world. With that, I'll conclude with details on how to learn more. PACE, coming to an orbit near you in 2023.